All right, today I'm out here. I'm gonna be pulling out some torpedo grass. I thought I'd bring you along, show you exactly what this stuff is, why it sucks so bad to have in your garden, and just some tips that I found along the way to help eradicate it from your space. So first of all, we'll talk about what is torpedo grass. I got a couple of samples here, a few things I want to show you, but this is the grass portion that'll show itself above the ground. Typical green leafy looking grass. Usually has one blade of grass sticking straight up with some others shooting off of the side. But it's what is underground that really becomes the problem. It all kind of starts with this rhizome right here. You can see it kind of looks like ginger root, you know, underground. This is kind of like where it stores all of its energy and it's all stemming from. And you can see some of the roots that come down here off of the rhizome. So that's really what you want to get, focus on getting up out of the ground when you're trying to pull this stuff. So you can see out of the rhizome, there'll be some shoots that come up and it'll either form grass or it'll form other shoots that run along down underneath the ground. So I got this piece here. This is a little rhizome nodule here on the side, and it's created this shoot, and this will run underground for feet and feet. I've pulled up sections that are at least 10 to 12 feet long. So you can recognize it by this bright white, very slick, shiny, kind of tubular root. And along this shoot, where the nodes are, it'll shoot up vertically and expose the grass above the surface. And this runner can basically live anywhere from like 2 inches below the ground, even all the way up to like 10 or 12 inches beneath the ground, depending upon your soil conditions. So if you got sandy soil, it's probably gonna be a little bit deeper. If you got harder compacted clay soil, it's probably gonna be not as deep, you know, just below the surface. One more thing I wanted to point out, the leading edge of these runners is extremely sharp. This is where it gets its name, torpedo, because the tip of that looks like a tip of a torpedo. Very sharp, like a needle. So any attempts to try and block this stuff from growing needs to be something that's impenetrable, like concrete. If you are, imagine this is below the ground and you're just pulling on this grass and it breaks off and you get this portion, but this stays underground, you're out of luck. It's gonna grow back on you, and you didn't get it. So you have to make sure you get the entire piece out. Another thing, if here again, this is below the ground and you're up here, you're pulling on this and it comes off like that, and you left this underground, you're out of luck. It's still gonna grow back on you, and you haven't gotten it. And also, if you got your hand down in the ground and you're pulling, and you know, you pull all this out, but you leave this little part in the ground that stays in there, it's gonna regrow and come back on you. So some people ask me, well, can I just till it all up and you know, rake it out and get all the little chunks out? I do not recommend that, because any little piece left behind is kind of like you just toss the seed out there for the torpedo grass to restart all over again. So any kind of mechanical ways to eradicate it from the machine is just gonna chop the stuff up and spread it, which you do not want. So unfortunately, the best thing I found to do is just get it out manually by hand. So a little backstory on how I got here with all this torpedo grass is that I went ahead and I covered my entire yard with, you know, like overlapping cardboard. So it's a good 2 to 3 layers thick of cardboard, and dumped about 6 inches of mulch on top of that. And it looked really nice. So happy with it. But this torpedo grass and this tip just poked right through the cardboard. The cardboard didn't phase it at all. And it all started shooting back up through it. And became really difficult to try and eradicate this stuff with that thick layer of mulch and trying to get at the roots and everything. So I pretty much kind of let it go. I've focused on a good portion up here and gotten it completely eradicated. So now I'm working through this, and it's basically growing back into like sod pretty much. So that's what torpedo grass is. So let's see how we can get this stuff out. I'm going to show you a couple of different methods today. One is with a shovel, where it's gotten really thick, kind of like sod. Another method I'm going to show you is just by hand, where there's not so much of it, and you just want to focus on getting a little portion out. So let's get into it. Let's get out some torpedo grass. I just have a couple items today that I'm using to help me with the job. Have some trash cans. The reason why, you do not want to try and chop and drop this stuff. You don't want to try and put it in your compost pile. When you get it out, you want to throw it away, get it as far away from your property as you can. You don't want this stuff lingering around to respawn on you. I also have a file. This file I'm using to sharpen my shovel. If you're using the shovel when you have really thick mat of this stuff and you want to kind of get it out, like sections of the sod, you don't want to keep jabbing your shovel down in there, because you're just going to keep breaking up small parts, and you don't want that. You want to just one nice jab into the ground and then move on to the next section. So for my shovel, I have a pony shovel here. It's nice and heavy. This is really nice thick steel that can hold an edge. So that's, I use my file to sharpen the edge of this, and it does a really good job at taking out sections of sod. Okay, so here I am. I have this section. It looks like, you know, really thick, dense sod that I'm going to take out with the shovel. If you have just little portions of it popping up, I wouldn't go in and use the shovel. So this is kind of method number one for removing sod with torpedo grass in it. I just want to, like I said, just one nice sharp jab down, move over, jab it down again, wiggle a little bit back and forth. And I'm just making a section about a foot wide, something that I can manage in my hand and not go too crazy. Then I'm gonna break it up even further into little squares. Okay, so once I got everything cut into little sections, I'm just gonna get my hands, reach under as far as I can. A lot of the sand is just gonna fall through, but that's a good chunk of the torpedo grass. You can see all the runners underneath. Here's some of the rhizome, but we're not done yet. That's just part of it. throw that in the trash can. Another section of it. That stuff's like spaghetti. So now, once you've gotten the big chunk out, you have to come back through and get all these little parts that you didn't get before. Some of them are just gonna be loose. Other ones are gonna be stuck in the ground. So you don't wanna go through and just yank on everything, because everything's just gonna pop and break. So get all the loose stuff out. That'll just come right out. And then what I like to do is work next to a clean section of ground that I know doesn't have any torpedo grass in it. And I'll start to sweep the clean dirt or whatever into that area and expose the roots that I did not get. And then once you start to expose those, you can lift them out. Here again, pull gently, don't rip it out. Sometimes I'll work my finger down underneath so I know I'm getting on the underside. And here I can feel a rhizome right there. I broke it in half, but since I'm using my fingers, see, I broke that in half under the ground, but since I was using my fingers, I felt it break. So I knew I had to get two sections out of there. So this is the stuff, you know, you need to get out. And then it's just, you know, a matter of working through nice and slow, moving the soil back as you go through it and clean it out. I'm throwing every little piece I get into the trash can. This is an interesting piece. You see the rhizome here? It's attached to this runner. It goes along, and there's another piece of rhizome attached to the same runner. And don't ignore any small spots. You have to get them all. And if a little edge breaks off while you're pulling it out, like say this portion broke off and fell down, make sure you pick that up and throw it away. And so that is how I remove torpedo grass. It's a very tedious process. You're down on the ground, you know, bending over a lot, so it's kind of rough on the back and everything, but this is why I found, you know, the best method at eradicating this stuff, just getting it out completely. So let's go over to this section over here that I did just this way about like 3 or 4 weeks ago. And another tip that you want to do is you want to come back a few weeks later, and you want to be on the lookout for
stuff that may pop back up. And you have to catch it as soon as possible, because if you let this stuff go, it's just gonna start to run and spread again. So it's almost impossible to get it 100% the first time when you're removing all the sod. You're gonna get stuff like this that pops back up. What I do is I come back and just kind of start to clear the dirt and whatever else around it. I give it a little gentle tug. If it doesn't want to come out, I just keep digging. And I put my finger in like a probe and feel around. And if it feels like it's going deeper, you just have to keep digging deeper. And so you can see it's starting to get down in there a good four inches right now. What I'm doing is I'm using two fingers on either side of the chute to remove some of the dirt. You can see how sandy my soil is right here. It just keeps wanting to fall back in the hole. So I'm gonna have to clear out more area and keep pulling the sand out. So I hope you guys can see this, but this is the chute that's coming up out of the ground, and you can see the white runner right there. And I'm going to put my fingers underneath the runner and slowly pull up and kind of work along the length of it. And this end was free, so I just pulled it all through. And you can see where I was pulling it before, that portion broke off and all this was left underground, so it started growing again. So let me see this side if it wants to come free or not. Here again, just giving a gentle tug, and sometimes it'll break free and just want to come for you. Other times it'll be stubborn and stick in there. So there you go, that was all underneath. So I found this section, thought I'd show you guys, that I just pulled out. Here's the start of it. Keeps going and going and going. Going until bang, there's that sharp pointy tip. That section's about 6 foot long.